my point. See, nice. In the second point, can you tell what is the position of this point to the observer? Is the observer?
It is above HP and behind VP.
Correct. It is above HP and behind VP. This is the second quadrant. Okay. Next, whenever my point lies in the third quadrant, what is the position of this point?
Below HP and behind VP, sir.
It is below HP and behind VP to the observer. Okay, you remember we are making all the drawings with respect to first quadrant only. The observer is here only. Okay, with respect to the observer, we are going to draw the front view, top view, and side view. Okay, this is the third quadrant. Whenever a point lies in the third quadrant, it is below HP and below HP and behind VP. Now, this is the fourth quadrant. Okay.
Below HP,
below HP and in front of VP, sir.
Good. This is whenever a point lies in the fourth quadrant, it is below HP and in front of VP. Okay, so you should understand. Okay, whenever the point lies in different quadrants, whenever a point lies in first quadrant, it is above HP, in front of VP. Whenever a point lies in second quadrant, it is above HP and behind VP. Whenever a point lies in the third quadrant, it is below HP and behind VP. And whenever a point lies in the fourth quadrant, it is below HP and in front of VP. And we discussed about the front view, top view. Okay. Can you anyone tell me, whenever my point lies in first quadrant, where will be your front view and top view? I explained, hope you understood in the last class.
Front view will be above HP and top view will be below.
Top will be below. How will you get below HP?
By rotating within the clockwise direction.
Okay. So you have to understand. Okay. Now I explain. Whenever my point lies in the first quadrant, okay, projection of the points, this is your reference line. Always you have to represent with the reference line. Okay. Next, point lies in the first quadrant means, suppose my point B lies 40 mm above HP and 50 mm in front of VP. First, always you have to draw the front view. Okay. Front view means you take any point anywhere, then mark a point at a distance of 40 mm. Okay, this is the 40 mm distance. It may be any dimension. Okay. This is the 40 mm. And how we are going to represent front view? It is B dash or
B dash.
B dash. Good. So this is B dash. Okay. All the front view are going to represent with the help of single dash. Okay, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, like that. Okay, this is your front view. Okay, next, important is top view. So what you are going to do is, as I said, in order to draw the top view, you have to rotate this horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. And this plane is common to your first quadrant and fourth quadrant. You have to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. When you rotate the horizontal plane in clockwise direction, the top view will come below. Okay, for that, what you are going to do? Okay, just mark any distance. Okay, I say this is 50 mm. Okay, take 50 mm from the same projection line. This is called as projection line. Okay. And you see whatever dimension is 50, I say, okay. You have to represent like this. This is the dimension. It's a dimension line. You have to put the arrow mark. Okay. This should be thin line. And this should be also thin line. Because we are going to do the projection of point. Okay. Then what is the notation of your top view?
That's
how you are going to represent?
B.
It is B. Okay. This is your top view. Okay. This is your top view. Top view is going to rotate. So, because top view means you are going to see like this. So, it goes below the reference line. Okay. This is how to represent the front view and top view. Okay, so B dash is front view and B is top view, and side views I'll explain in the next problem. Okay, coming problem, side view represented by B double dash. Okay, first you understand the first view, front view and top view in different quadrants. So this is the position of point in the first quadrant. Okay, next you have to draw the projection of point whenever the point lies in the second quadrant. Okay, my point C lies some 40 mm above HP and 50 mm behind VP. Can you tell how to start this projection of point whenever point lies in the second quadrant?
Both
front
view above the reference line.
First, you have to start with front view or top view.
Front view.
No, no, don't go start with top view. It is very difficult.
Front view.
Always, you have to start with front view. Front view means it is above or below HP only. So always, you have to start with front view. Then after that, you are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction to get the top view. Okay, so my point C lies at a distance of 40 mm above HP and 50 mm behind VP. Okay, so above HP means directly you take. Okay, anyhow, it is above HP C dash. Okay, it is above HP means above reference line only. So you take the given dimension. Okay, say 40 mm, 40 or whatever it is. I am taking 30 mm above HP and 50 mm behind VP. Okay, now can you tell me how to draw your top view? How to draw your top view?
Sir, we have to rotate the HP upside, sir.
This
like
plane
in clockwise direction.
This one or this one?
The left side one, sir.
Now left side, good. Okay, you see, this is the plane which is common to second quadrant and third quadrant. Don't rotate this plane. You have to rotate the plane in clockwise direction. Whenever you rotate the plane in clockwise direction, the top view goes above the reference line. Okay, my point is C, 30 mm above HP and 50 mm behind VP. So already I have 30 mm. Okay, remaining dimension is 50 mm, means you have to take 20 mm from this point, or you can take 50 mm from this reference line. So complete the top view. The top is represented by symbol C. Okay, once you draw the dimension, so you have to mention full dimension. Don't write 20 here, because you have to represent the entire dimension from the reference line. Okay, this is the projection of the point C, which is 30 mm above HP and 50 mm behind VP. So this is the point projection of point. Means you have to highlight this point. Okay, you have to highlight this point because you are doing projection of points, and this should be thin line and this should be your dimension line. Okay, you have to show it arrow mark. Okay, guys, all of you completed geometrical constructions?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I gave 10 problems.
Yes, sir. Got it. I mean, yes, completed, sir.
Any doubts in pentagon, hexagon?
No, sir.
Circle?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Have you divided circle into 12 parts, A parts?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is the interior angle of any polygon? Can you tell me?
180 minus
360 by number
360
of sides.
360 by n, sir.
Good. Okay, that is the formula to find out interior
internal angles.
Any polygon, don't forget, because we are going to use that formula whenever it comes to projection of planes, projection of solids and isometric projection. Okay, this is my second quadrant point. Okay, now we'll draw the projection of point which lies in the third quadrant. Okay, my point D lies at a distance of 30 mm below HP and 50 mm behind VP. Okay, can you tell me how to start this projection of point?
So front view will be below the reference line.
Good.
And top view will be above the reference line.
Top view will be the above reference. How will you get the top view will be above reference line?
by rotating HP.
Good. Okay. See. First, you have to draw the front view. The front view is below the horizontal plane, below the reference line. So, in order to draw the top view, you have to rotate the horizontal plane in that clockwise direction. Okay, my point D is 30 mm below HP and 50 mm behind VP. Okay, so you start. Okay, you take anywhere. So, draw a point D dash. As I said, remember, don't draw top view directly. First, you draw the front view because it is above HP or below HP, depending upon that quadrant. Okay, and once you draw the front view, then only you have to draw the top view. Okay, this is my dimension 30 mm. It is below HP, and so XY. Okay. So you have to draw, this is the HP and this is AP. This is the plane, vertical plane, this is the horizontal plane. So because we are going to draw in the two dimension. This is 30 mm. Next, my point 50 mm behind AP. Okay, so what you can do, already I have 30 mm. So you take another 20 mm dimension, or you take the 50 mm dimension from the reference line XY. And one more thing, always you have to represent with lowercase only. Okay, don't represent uppercase letter. Suppose you write uppercase letter, it is wrong because these are the views. Okay, so you have to represent with the lowercase letter only. Okay, this is 50 mm. Okay, and this is a point, projection of point, which lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm behind VP. This is the projection of point which lies in the third quadrant. Okay, understood?
Yes, sir.
Good. Next, I am going to draw the projection of point which lies in the fourth quadrant.
Sir, excuse me, sir.
Now tell me.
Can you explain the position of can you explain that again, sir? In the third quadrant.
Third quadrant, sir?
Hmm.
Not understood. Okay. First, you tell me, where is my point? Point is lies in third quadrant.
Sir, it is behind VP. And below HP, sir.
Good. You understood that one, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. First, you have to start with the front view, right? Front view is,
yes, sir,
below HP, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just to analyze, my point D lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm behind VP. Okay, always you have to start with the front view. Okay, it is below HP, right?
Okay, sir.
First, yes, you have, sir, to draw the, okay, now the front view. I am telling, don't draw the top view directly. First, you draw the front view, my point D dash. You remember, the front view is represented by dash, single dash.
D dash. Okay, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
And what is my point? It lies at a distance of 30 mm. 30 mm. Okay. So my point lies at a distance of 30 mm. This is your front view, right?
Yes,
understood?
Sir. Yes, okay, sir. Understood, sir.
Next, you have to draw the top view. Top view means you are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. You remember this plane, which is common to first and fourth quadrant, but my point lies in the third quadrant. This plane you have to consider. Okay, this one.
Yes, sir.
This you have to rotate in the clockwise direction, right?
Yes, sir.
No, whenever you rotate the clockwise direction, so that it touches the vertical plane, which is above the horizontal plane, right? It goes here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. In that case, so your top view will be above the
horizontal plane.
So, it will be above the horizontal plane,
right?
That's what I mean. You wrote that 50 centimeters below in the previous diagram, sir. So that was the doubt.
Sorry, guys, because I thought of that will be in fourth quadrant. Sorry. Okay. Really sorry. Okay.
Got it, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Front, top view, it goes. No, I thought of that the point will be in the fourth quadrant. Okay, sorry. Now I am explaining the point lies in the third quadrant. The point D lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm in front of, behind VP means. So that will be above the reference line. Okay, you have to take. You have to take the intersection point here only, okay? Don't take anywhere. So that is the intersection point. From this point only, you have to take a 50 mm above the reference line. Mark this point as D, okay? Then you have to complete the topic. This is 50 mm, okay? So, whenever a point lies in the third quadrant, the front view will be below the reference line and top view will be the above reference line. Hope understood this third quadrant?
Yes, sir.
Good. Okay, next we'll go to the fourth quadrant. My point E lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm in front of VP. Okay, then how to draw this? Projection.
Sir, so we have to take the front view first, sir.
Front view first, okay. 30 mm below HP.
And then we have to take the top view, and then the horizontal plane will rotate downwards, sir. Clockwise direction.
Means you get both front view and top view in the below the reference line only, right? In fourth quadrant.
Yes, sir.
Good. So you see, first. Whenever point lies in the fourth quadrant, the position of the point will be below HP and in front of VP. Always you have to draw the front view. Okay, so here it is your front view. My point E lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm in front of VP. So first, anywhere you locate the point E dash, you take distance of 30 mm, mark a point, okay, and mark it with E dash. Next. My point 50 mm in front of VP. So in that case, what I say, you have to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. Okay, means whenever you rotate the horizontal plane in clockwise direction, so the point will go below the reference line only. Okay. Okay, just you understand the procedure correctly. So once you understand, you can do any number of the problem, but concept you have to understand properly. Okay. My point E lies 30 mm below HP and 50 mm in front of VP. So first you have to draw the front view. It is 30 mm below HP. And in order to draw the top view, you have to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. So that we'll get both front view and top view will be in the will be below the reference line. Okay, so this is how to draw the projection of points in different quadrants. Any doubts?
No, sir. Got it, sir. Yes.
Okay. Whenever point lies in the first quadrant, so you will get the front view above, top view below. Whenever a point lies in the second quadrant, you'll get both front view and top view above the reference line. When the point lies in the third quadrant, the front view will be below and top view will be above reference line. Whenever the point lies in the fourth quadrant, both front view and top view will be below the reference line. Okay. Next, I'm giving the example. Okay. So this, I hope you understood all this one. Okay. Next. Now I am giving another point. So you tell me what is the position of this point. Okay, my point F exactly lies on the horizontal 50 mm in front of VP. Can you analyze and tell me how to draw this projection? Okay, my point F lies exactly on the horizontal plane and it is 50 mm in front of VP. Where will get front view and top view?
So the front view will be on the line XY and
good.
The top view will be below the plane.
Good, exactly right. Okay, so whenever point lies on the plane itself, means we don't have any distance at all. So whenever a point like this, it is common to give a first quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay, and this 50 mm in front of it. Then how about your top view? How about top view? Correct, good. Okay, so my point lies exactly on the reference line. We don't have any distance at all. In that case, what you can do directly, you have to locate that point F dash on the reference line. Okay, in order to draw the top view, so we have to rotate this point in the clockwise direction. So the top view will go below the reference line. You take a distance of 50 mm from the reference line. Okay, that will be your top view. Okay, understood, students? Any doubts in this one?
Sir, can you repeat it again, sir? Like the front view.
Okay, good. Okay, so actually we studied first quadrant and fourth quadrant, right? In first quadrant the point is above HP, and in the fourth quadrant the point is below HP. But sometimes the point exactly lies on the horizontal plane. So in that case, it is common to your first quadrant and fourth quadrant. Means we don't have distance at all. Suppose if you're having some distance, you're going to take above or below. Suppose if it is above 10 mm, means you're going to take 10 mm here. Suppose if it is 30 mm below a reference line, you are going to take 30 mm here. But in this case, the point which lies exactly on the plane, but some distance in front of VP. So as I said, so because we don't have distance, well, because it's common to the first quadrant and fourth quadrant, in that case, suppose the distance is not given, directly you have to represent on the reference line. Understood?
Sir, you mean on the origin, sir? I mean the front view lies on the origin, sir?
Origin line, XY line only.
Okay.
Because we don't have distance, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Because we don't have a distance, so front view always lies on the origin line or a reference line. Okay, in order to draw the top view, you have to rotate this plane in the clockwise direction, because this point is common to the first quadrant and fourth quadrant. So already we got front view. In order to draw the top view, you have to rotate the plane in the clockwise direction, so top view go below the reference line. Any doubts?
No, sir.
So those who are having any doubts, please ask me. I'll clarify, try to understand the concept. Anybody?
We understood, sir.
Good. Okay, so you should not have any doubts. Suppose you are having any doubts, please ask in between so that I'll clarify, but try to understand the concept properly. Next, okay. So engineering graphics is the language of engineers. Okay, you have to think, you have to analyze, because everything you are going to express in terms of lines, points, planes, like that. Okay, that's why it is called as the language of engineers. Okay, notation, everything. Okay, next. Next. My point, just you take my point G, okay, just to consider my point G lies exactly on the horizontal plane and some 30 mm behind a vertical plane. How to draw this front view and top view? Can you imagine and tell me?
Front view will be on the reference line always.
Okay.
So the front view will be on the origin line.
Good.
And top, and the, top view will be on above the horizontal plane.
Reference line.
Good. Okay. Whenever I'm taking, so starting I took here, but now I'm taking the point here. What is the position of point? The point G lies exactly on the horizontal plane and some distance behind VP. So in, as I say, first you have to start with your front view. You have to draw with your front view. You have to represent exactly on the reference line or origin line and mark this point as a G dash. A G dash. Now, where will your top view?
Above the reference line, sir.
I will get above the
reference line, sir.
How will get above the reference line?
Because we are rotating the horizontal plane clockwise upwards, sir.
Correct. Good. So this is the plane which is common to your third quadrant and second quadrant. So because my point lies and this point is common to second and third quadrant, you have to rotate this horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. When you rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction, the position will go above the reference line. Okay. So take whatever distance given in the problem, take that much of distance, okay, mark that point as G, okay. Then you have to mark like this, okay. This is a dimension 30 mm. Okay, so point G position you have to understand, it is the point G lies exactly on the horizontal plane and 30 mm behind VP. In this case, the front view lies exactly on the origin line, okay, and the top view will go above the reference line because you are going to rotate the plane in the clockwise direction. So this is the second example. Next, just you try analyze this problem. Okay, next. My point H lies exactly on the vertical plane and some 40 mm above the horizontal plane. Can you imagine and tell me where you get front view and top view?
So yeah. The front view will be above the vertical, I mean above the horizontal plane, sir.
Good. How about the top view?
Top view will be on the horizontal plane, sir.
Good. Exactly right. Okay. Okay. So here, my point H lies exactly on the vertical plane and 40 mm above HP. Okay. So 40 mm above HP means anyhow, that is common to the first and second quadrant. Always we have to start with the front view. Okay. This is 40 mm. You are going to represent it as H dash. Okay. Next, can you tell me where is your top view?
On the reference line, sir.
On the reference line.
How it is on the reference line?
Because it is located on the exactly on the vertical plane, sir.
Good. Okay. So here, so we don't have any distance, okay, behind or in front, okay, because exactly lies on the vertical plane means you have to represent the top view exactly on the reference line XY. Okay, this is your top view. Okay, and dimension you have to mark. Whatever dimension given in the problem, you have to mark that dimension. So this is your 30 or 40, whatever it is given in the problem. So understood? Any doubts, guys?
Sir, there's no need to rotate horizontal plane in this problem, no, sir.
No, not required. Okay, because my point exactly lies on the vertical plane. No, and there is no necessity of rotating, right? Because no distance at all.
Sir, okay, can sir. You explain this problem once more, sir.
This one, okay, good.
Conditions also you tell, sir. Once.
Okay, condition. You see. My point H lies 30 mm above HP and exactly on the VP. Understood? This is the position of point first.
Yes, sir.
Now, position of point is, it is 30 mm above HP and it lies exactly on the VP. Means it is neither behind nor in front. Okay, it exactly lies on the VP. Understood? This is a position of point first. You understand position of point first?
Yes, sir. Okay.
my point H lies 30 mm above HP and exactly on the VP. Means there is no in front or there is no behind. So it exactly lies on the VP, but it is 30 mm above HP. This is the position of point. Got it? Okay, suppose you're having doubts, ask me. First, you understand the position.
Understood. Okay.
As you know, this is your horizontal plane. The plane which is parallel to the floor is your horizontal plane. The plane, what you are seeing, it is the plane which is parallel to the wall. It is called as vertical plane. Okay. And whatever the intersection line, we are calling it as this reference line. Okay. So, whenever my point lies some distance above HP and exactly on the vertical plane, as I said, you have to start with the front view. Anyhow, it is 30 mm above HP. 30 mm above HP means first you have to take a distance of 30 mm above the HP, mark this point as H dash and represent it as 30. Okay. Now coming to the top view, it is most important. Okay. In remaining cases, what you are going to do, you are going to rotate the plane in the clockwise direction, but here exactly lies on the VP means, okay, there is no rotation is at all. Directly, it is lying on the horizontal means, we don't have any distance either in front or behind. Means in such cases, just you draw the line and represent that point exactly on the origin line. That's it. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
So when do we rotate the planes and what circumstance do we rotate the horizontal plane, sir?
So when I'll tell you, okay, when you are going to rotate the horizontal plane, suppose if you are having some distance like 30 mm in front of VP or 30 mm below HP or 30 mm behind VP, or 30 mm behind VP like that, in that case you have to rotate, okay?
Okay.
But my point lies exactly in the vertical plane. Means you see, this is your front view, okay? H dash, directly you get your top view, okay? Like this. Yes. No need, okay? No need to rotate. So whenever,
sir, excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
What we drive on the right side is the front view, no, sir?
Now this one is front view. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Yes, sir.
This is front view and your top view. Top view is represented by H.
Yes, sir.
And it lies exactly on the reference line.
Yes, sir.
Whenever a point lies exactly on the vertical plane, you will get the top view on the reference line. Okay.
Got it, sir. Yes, sir.
And front view will be depending upon your quadrant. If it is in first and second quadrant, the front view goes above the reference line. Okay. And whenever the point lies in third and fourth quadrant, the front view goes below the reference line. Okay. Like that, I'll give one more problem. You only analyze and tell. Okay. So here I gave H. Okay. Next, I'm giving I, my point I. Okay. Can you tell me what is the position of point here?
Sir, it's below the horizontal plane and on the vertical plane, sir.
It is below horizontal plane and?
And exactly on the vertical plane.
That's why first you have to understand the position of point. Okay. My point I lies exactly on the vertical plane and some distance below the HP. Okay. Now, you understand how to draw the projection of points. First front view and next top view. Can you tell me how to start with the front view?
So front view will be below the horizontal plane.
Front view will be below the horizontal plane, fine.
And top view will be on the vertical plane, sir. See, top on the horizontal plane, sir.
Exactly on the original line, right?
Yes, sir.
Good. Okay. Anybody can explain?
Sir, take a point in the third quadrant, sir.
Third quadrant. It is below HP. How about top view? I am asking about top view. Where it lies? It is above or below?
So above.
Above means don't not distance is not there. How are you going to represent?
Top view is on.
Top view is on the reference line, sir.
Good. Okay, because whenever you see, that's why I said okay, you have to understand the concept properly. Before that, I explained all the four quadrants. Once you analyze all those four quadrants, then only you can recognize such kind of problems. Okay, that's why first you understand the position. Next, you have to draw the front view, and then you have to draw the top view. Okay, first you understand the position of point I. My point I lies exactly on the vertical plane and some distance below the horizontal plane. Okay, in such cases, okay, anyhow, you know, whenever point lies below the HP, always you have to start with the front view. Okay, front view means my point I lies 30 mm below HP and lies exactly on the vertical plane. Okay, whenever vertical plane is there, okay, so start with front view. My point I lies at a distance of 30 mm below the HP. Mark a point at a distance of 30 mm below HP. Okay, my this is my front view. Next, how about top view? Top view
is on the reference line.
On the reference line only, because here we don't have distance. You remember, whenever they will give in front or behind, then only you think of rotating the horizontal plane. Suppose if they give exactly on the vertical plane, so no need to take the distance directly. You have to locate that point on the reference line. Okay, this is your top view and this is your front view. Okay, now I am giving an example K. My point K lies exactly on the horizontal plane and 30 mm behind VP. Okay, now can you analyze this? Where you get the front view and where you get the top view?
The front view will be on the line.
Front view will be on the line. Exactly, right. How about your top view?
The top view will be above the reference plane, sir.
How
as we rotate that horizontal plane, sir.
Above the reference line. Good.
Yes, sir.
Good. Exactly right. Okay. So that like that you have to analyze. Okay. First, anybody, any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay. Those who are any doubts, sir. Okay. Please don't hesitate to ask your clarify your doubts. Okay, don't keep any doubts. Okay, try to understand properly. Okay, once you understand easily, you can do the problem. But understanding is most important. Okay, you see, my point K lies exactly on the horizontal plane, and it is 30 mm behind VP. Okay, as I said, you have to start with the front view. My point K lies at a distance of, it is exactly on the horizontal plane. Means front view will be exactly on the reference line, and you have to represent with K dash. Okay, so this is the notation of front view whenever the point lies exactly on the horizontal plane. Okay, now we have to get the top view. So as I said, in order to draw the top view, you have to rotate this plane. Okay, you see this plane, this is a common to second and third quadrant. You have to rotate this plane in the clockwise direction. Whenever you rotate the plane in the clockwise direction, the top view will go above the reference line. So whatever distance given in the problem, take that distance. Okay, say 30 or 40, whatever it is. Okay, 40 mm behind VP. Okay. So this is the position of point It is lies exactly on the horizontal plane 40 mm behind VP, means front view will get exactly on the reference line and the top view will be above the reference line because you are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. Okay, like that, can you analyze this point, first point? J, okay, I am telling you. Some point J, okay. Can you tell me J now?
Sir, the front view will be on the horizontal plane.
Good.
I mean on the reference line, and the top view will be below the reference line, sir.
How it is below the reference line?
Because we rotate that horizontal plane downwards in clockwise direction.
Good. Okay. Like that, you have to analyze my point J. Lies exactly on the horizontal plane and 40 mm in front of VP. So in that case, as I said, first you have to start with the front view. So here J is my point, lies exactly on the horizontal plane, means directly you have to take, because no distance above or below, it is exactly on the horizontal plane, means the front view will be exactly on the reference line and the front view is represented by a J dash. Okay, next, to get the top view, okay, and you think of your plane. This is a plane which is common to first and fourth quadrant. You remember, they'll ask what is the position of point J, whether it is in first quadrant or fourth quadrant?
It's in the first quadrant, sir.
How about fourth quadrant? No, it is a point common to first and fourth quadrant, you remember, okay?
So we can draw both on the both sides now, sir?
No, you see my point J, which is common to first and fourth quadrant, okay? Suppose point lies here, it is in first quadrant. Suppose my point lies here, it is in fourth quadrant. Whenever the point lies exactly in the horizontal plane, because it's a common to the first and fourth quadrant. In that case, you have to write position as first bar fourth quadrant, right?
But where do we draw, sir? Like in the first quadrant or in the fourth quadrant?
No. You should write like this. Okay, the J is in first bar fourth quadrant. Like that, you have to draw position. Okay, but your projection will be below only. This is your projection of the point. Okay, but position is, you have to draw right like this, first or fourth. Now, can you tell me what is the position of point H? What is the position of point H?
First and second quadrant.
Common to first and second
quadrant. Good. It is the position, it is common to first and second quadrant. Because my vertical plane is common to first and second quadrant. Now, how about point K?
It's common.
Common to second and third quadrant.
Now, the point K, because this plane is common to second and third quadrant, you have to write H like this. It is common to the first and second quadrant. You see that diagram? First and second quadrant. No, they'll ask position. Okay, position, and this is a projection. Projection is same, okay, what I explained. This is a procedure, okay, but position, you should be careful, okay. Don't write only first, okay, because it's common. Next, point K. The point K will be common to second and third quadrant. The point K will be common to second and third quadrant. And finally, we have the point J, which is common to the first and fourth quadrant. Like that. First, they'll ask position and then they'll tell to draw the projections. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Good. Okay. Now, can you summarize whenever point lies exactly on HP and in front of VP, where will get front view and top view? Okay. Now, you have to summarize. Whenever point lies exactly on HP and in front of VP, What is the position where it will be front view and top view?
Front
view will be on reference plane.
Good.
Top view will be below.
Good. Good. Okay. And position of point is in first and fourth quadrant. Now you analyze point H. First you tell the position and you analyze where you'll get front view and top view. Point H.
Position will be first and quadrant.
Good. How about front view and top view?
So the front view will be above the reference line and top view will be on the reference line.
Good. Okay. Now analyze point K.
Position is common for second and third quadrant, sir.
Okay.
And the front view will be on the reference line and top view will be the front view will be on the it will be above the reference line and top view will be on the reference line, sir.
Okay, don't make confusion. Can you tell me once again point K?
So front view will be on the reference line and good. Top view will be above.
Good, correct. So position is, it is common to second and third quadrant. So whenever point lies exactly on the plane, horizontal plane, front view will be exactly on that line only. And top view means you are going to rotate that plane in the clockwise direction. Means the top view will go above the reference line. Okay. Whenever the point is common to second and third quadrant. Now you tell me position of I, point I.
So it's common to third and fourth quadrant.
Common to third and fourth quadrant. Good. Okay. Now it analyze front view first.
Front view will be below the reference line.
Below reference line. Good. How about
top
view? Top view.
Top view will be
top
on,
view
the,
will
reference
be on the reference line.
Top view below or above? I point A.
On the reference line, sir.
Good. Okay. So point I means it is below HP. And exactly on the vertical plane means you will get anyhow the top view exactly on the reference line and front view will be below the reference line. Okay, like that you have to analyze. Okay, so you have analyzation is most important. Okay, you have to analyze properly. So where is my position of point? Where you get the front view and top view? Any doubts, guys? Okay, these are another four positions. Starting four position, first, second, third, and fourth. Now I explained the common position. Between first and second, second and third, third and fourth, and first and fourth. Okay, common position. Okay, how to represent front view and top view? Okay, any doubts?
Excuse me, sir.
No, tell me.
Sir, take one point in the third quadrant, sir.
Okay.
It is 10 centimeter.
Just a minute.
Tell me.
My point, okay, you tell X, any point X. 10 centimeter, 10 below the reference line, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Take 20 mm, this one also.
20 mm below HP and 20 mm in front of it, behind it, right? Tell me, what is the position of point? Tell me, ask me, any doubts? Okay. Hope 20 mm common, right? 20 mm below HP and 20 mm behind HP, right? I think this is your problem, right? Common distance, right? Guys?
Yes, sir.
That's it, sir. I guess, sir.
Means common dimension.
Yes, sir.
Okay. My point, Y lies at a distance of 20 mm below HP and 20 mm behind it. In that case, how to draw the front view and top view?
So the front view will be below the reference line.
Now.
And the top view will be above the reference line, sir.
Correct. Okay. Same thing. Good. Okay. X, Y. So whenever point lies in the third quadrant, the front view will be the below reference line. What you can do? Okay. So take, mark a point, take a distance. So 20 mm below the reference line. Okay. Point and mark it as Y dash. Okay. Because we are going to represent with single dash. Okay. Now, how to write the top view?
Sir, it will be above the reference line.
How will get the above reference line?
Because we rotate the horizontal.
Sir, we'll rotate it clockwise.
Now, okay. So you are going to rotate the plane in the clock, because this is a plane which is common to second and third quadrant. You are going to rotate this plane in the clockwise direction. When you rotate the this plane in the clockwise direction, the top view go above the reference line. So you get the top view above the reference line, which lies at a distance of 20 mm behind it. So I am represented by Y. Okay, so this is Y. Okay, now can anybody analyze? Okay, my point Z lies at a distance of 20 mm from both the planes. How to represent this one? Okay, see this problem. My point Z lies at a distance of 20 mm below HP and 20 mm in front of VP. Okay, how to represent?
So the front view will be below the reference line.
Front view will be below the reference line. Good. How about top view?
And top view will be below the reference line itself.
Now what is the distance?
Distance will be the same, sir. On the same point to like two dimensions.
Correct. So you see, like for that purpose only I gave this example. So whenever you are having such kind of things, okay, I'll explain how to represent the front view and top view. Okay. My point Z lies at a distance of 20 mm below HP and 20 mm in front of VP. Means my point Z is in fourth quadrant. Okay. Fourth quadrant is the front view go below the reference line, that is Z dash, and this is 20 mm. Okay. This one I got front view. Where will get the top view?
Sir, below the reference line itself.
Below the reference, what is the dimension?
20 mm, sir.
20 mm. Already we had 20 mm because this is the intersection point where you get both front view and top view. In that case, representation is most important. First, always you have to write your front view, and then in the bracket you have to write your top view. Okay. So whenever you are having the common dimension like this, in that case the front view and top view, this is a representation. Understood? Because
yes,
the intersection, this is the intersection point. Because my point Z lies at a distance of 20 mm below HP and 20 mm in front of VP. First you drew the front view at a distance of 20 mm. And next you are going to draw the top view. In order to draw the top view, you are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction, and it is also at same distance, that is at a distance of 20 mm in front of VP. So we'll get the common intersection point because both dimensions are same. In this, in such cases, so whenever you are having intersection point, always you have to represent your front view. Okay, don't write top view first. So first you have to represent the front view, and then you have to write in the bracket your top view. This is the notation of front view and top view. Understood, guys? Any doubts?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. Okay. Any doubts? Till now, any doubts?
No, sir.
Suppose if you are having any doubts, you can ask me so that I'll explain with some other problem. Any doubts?
No, sir.
I hope all the concepts are clear.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. Now I am going to explain how to draw the side view. So till now you understood only the front view and top view. Now I'll explain how to draw the side view of a point. So students, all of you are having the sketchbook with you. Sketchbook and all necessary instruments are there.
Yes, sir.
Most of us have it, sir, but then there are a few who don't have.
No, actually, that's why I put it the message in the WhatsApp group. Okay, at least suppose you're having some white sheets or book, drawing book, you can do it. How many of you are not having the sketchbook? Tell me. Tell me clearly.
Sir, I don't have the sketchbook.
Where you are staying?
Sir, in Bihar, Bhagalpur.
No, you're not. No, you'll not get drawing book like white.
Sir, I got a white sheet.
You can do it in the white sheet, and then
I am doing on that, sir.
You have to upload in the Google Classroom. Okay, all of you join Google Classroom, guys.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
No. What I say, no, because out of 36, only 22 students have joined the Google Classroom. Okay, as I observed. How about remaining 14 students? What you are doing? Okay.
So we will post the link in the group, sir. We'll try to.
No, I have posted the Google Classroom code. Okay, Google Classroom code.
Yes, sir. We'll post the link in the group, sir. So
I'm going to post all the assignments, everything in the Google Classroom. So then only you'll come to know. Okay, so if you're not joining, you'll not come to know.
Sure, sir. Yes, sir.
That's why first those who have not joined the Google Classroom, first you join that Google Classroom because you'll get all the instruction in that Google Classroom. Once you are going to do the assignment, you are going to post your drawings, what you are doing, you are going to post all those, you have to upload all those assignment in that Google Classroom. Then only I can understand. Okay. So first step is you have to join the Google Classroom. Okay. Without fail. Those who have not joined. Okay. I have shared the Google Classroom code in your WhatsApp group. Okay, first you join the Google Classroom, okay, and then so whatever drawing, okay, don't okay, better you do practice because you are going to do in your house only. So keep all the drawings in a safe condition, okay, so because you are going to upload those sheets for evaluation, okay, hence I'm telling, so preserve properly all those is what you are doing, okay? Because each and everything carry marks, okay? You are having 40 marks, your internal assessment, okay? So based upon your, so what you are doing, sketches, and then your performance in the test like that, okay? That's why I'm telling. So do properly and preserve it. And then whenever we ask, you have to upload in the Google Classroom, okay? Next, I'll explain how to draw the side view. Okay, so before that, we should have, how you have the idea of quadrant. Next, we have RPP and NPP. Okay. In order to draw the side view, we should have the idea of RPP and LPP. RPP stands for right profile plane. Okay, my, whenever my observer is here, okay. So this is the right profile plane and this is the left profile plane. Understood? Okay. So whenever my observer is here, so this is your right, because this is the right to the observer, and whatever plane it is left to the observer is called as left profile plane. This is the left profile plane and this is the right profile plane to the observer. Okay, before drawing the side view, we should have the idea of RPP and LPP. Okay, so now I'll explain with one problem. Okay, okay, first I'll give the problem how will you draw all the three views. Okay. Okay, those who are having the sketchbook, better you write down this one and then you have to draw the views. Okay, draw all the three views for your practice. Okay. Draw all the three views of a point P. Draw all the three views of a point P lying lying 60 mm below HP drawing 60 mm below HP 70 mm in front of OP, in front of VP, and 40 mm from RP. Okay.
So should we write this on the plane side or the grid side?
Just on the plane side, okay, not grid side. Okay, okay. Don't write any statement on the grid side, okay? You have to write the problem statement only in the plane side. Guys, all of you have to note down this problem. Okay, so all of you have to note down, those who are having sketchbooks, okay, in the white sheet. Okay, so those who are not having sketchbooks, no problem. So just you write in the white sheet. Okay, just you note down this one. Okay, because in the drawing you have to practice a lot, that's why I'm giving this problem. Okay, all of you have to write this problem. Draw all the three views of a point P which is lying at a distance of 60 mm above HP, 70 mm in front of VP and 40 mm from RPP. RPP is the right profile plane, the plane which is right to the observer. Okay, so please all of you have to note down this problem. Okay, I'll explain how to draw all the three points, all the three projections. Already you know the front view and top view. I'll explain how to draw the side view. Okay. Can you note down this one? All of you note down this problem. Okay. Over, guys. Okay, have you finished writing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you tell me where does it lie? Which quadrant? Okay. You think of only
HP. It's in the first quadrant, sir.
Good. Okay. So whenever the statement is like this, and in the exam, no need to write your statement. Just you have to draw the projection. That's it. Okay. But in the sketchbook, you have to write the. This is called problem definition. Okay. It's the problem statement. You have to write with the pen. Okay. Now what I am going to do? You have to write everything with the pencil. Now. Okay. Sketch. You have to draw with the pencil. And the statement you have to draw, you have to write with the pen. Okay. First, you have to analyze which quadrant it is. It is in the first quadrant because it is 60 mm above HP and 70 mm in front of VP. Can you draw front view and top view at least first step? Okay.
Sir, we should draw quadrants on the grid side, na, sir?
No. Don't write. Okay, don't write anything here. Okay, this far, just for your understanding, I wrote this one. Okay, no need to draw this one. Directly.
So we should not write any theory, no, sir.
No. Just you have to write the statement. Next, the projection of points. Okay, what I explained. No, you have to draw front view and top view. That's it. Okay. In the exam, in the record book, whatever it is, don't write this one. Okay, because just for your understanding, I explained this one. Okay. Directly start with your projection of point. Okay, what you are going to do starting? So you are going to draw the reference line. Okay, first step. All of you have to draw the reference line XY. Over.
Yes, sir.
Okay, next, where will get your front view?
Sir, it will be above the reference line, sir.
Good. Above the reference line. Okay. So, first you draw the front view. You take distance of 60 mm. Anywhere you take 60 mm from the reference line, mark that point as P dash because it is there given clearly. P means you have to take P only. Okay. So, here so this is your 60 mm. This is the first step. How to locate the front view. Okay. Can you tell me how to write the top view? Where you'll get the top view?
Below, sir.
Below. How you get below the top view? Below the reference
by
line?
Rotating HP.
Sir, we rotate horizontal plane.
Correct. You are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. As you rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction, the top view go below the reference line. Okay. Here you are having intersection point, right? From the same point, and you have to highlight this one. Okay. Next, you take some 70 mm. Okay. From the reference line, mark that point as P and dimension as 70. So all of you do this one. Okay, first you draw the reference line. Take a distance of 60 mm. Locate a point at a distance of 60 mm. Mark that point as P dash. Then you write the dimension line. Okay, next. So in order to draw the top view, you are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction. The top will go below the reference line. So this dimension is your 70 mm. Okay, all of you finished this one. Okay, the first step, second step, third step. Everybody finished? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first you have to analyze which quadrant. It lies in the first quadrant, okay, above HP and below, above HP and in front of VP. So here you'll get the front view above the reference line and top view below the reference line. Okay, now I'll explain how to draw the side view. Okay, so for any projection, we are having three types of projection. One is a side view. One is front view and one is top view and one is side view. Okay. Okay. In order to draw the side view, okay, because you see, this is the point which is in first quadrant, means it is in right profile plane to the observer. So whenever point lies in the first and fourth quadrant, the point is in right profile plane to the observer. Whenever a point lies in second and third quadrant, the point lies in the left profile plane. Okay, you should keep in mind, okay, whenever point lies in the first and fourth quadrant, it is in right profile plane. Whenever a point lies in the second and third quadrant, the point is in left profile plane or LPP. Okay, now we start the side view. Okay, side view. Okay, they are given in front of VP and 40 mm from RPP. Okay, 40 mm from RPP means what you are going to do. So you take 40 mm. Okay, from this line you take 40 mm. Next step, RPP. RPP means right profile plane. Just you draw the vertical line. So in order to draw front view and top view, you are going to draw the horizontal reference line XY. And in order to draw your side view, so you have to draw the vertical reference line and mark that line as X1, Y1, you remember. Okay. To draw the front view and top view, you should have this reference line, okay, XY. And in order to draw the side view, you have to draw this vertical line. They are clearly given 40 mm from RPP, and from this line you take 40 mm, just you draw the reference line, okay, and you mark that line as X1, Y1. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then you suppose 40 mm from LPP means you have to take this side, okay. From RPP means you have to take towards this side. From LPP means you have to take towards left side. That is the difference.
So what about locating the, like, in the 3D diagram, sir?
No, not 3D diagram, okay. Just you draw XY, locate front view and top view, okay. This diagram is not required. 3D diagram you should not draw, okay. Only you have to locate the views, that's it, okay.
Now, so can you show the 40 mm to the 3D
diagram? Procedure for side view, remember, okay.
Yeah, sir, got it, sir.
No, okay.
So,
tell me.
Can you explain, can you show the 40 mm through the 3D diagram? Like how you represent it through the 3D diagram?
40 mm from RPP.
Yeah, can you show it in the 3D diagram? Like where exactly it is?
3D diagram. So 3D diagram, profile plane, okay. I can show above HP and in front of HP. Okay. So it is like in front of HP, no, so 30 mm from right profile plane, okay. So how you are taking in front like that? So we are assuming that one plane, okay, the plane which is towards your right side, okay. So how you are having this plane, okay. Can you see this diagram, guys?
Yes, sir. I got it.
I hope you understood this one concept.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I got an idea.
Okay, by seeing the diagram only you can analyze. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. First one is your horizontal plane, and this is your vertical plane. This is your right profile plane. Right? Right profile plane means the plane which is parallel to your vertical plane. Okay. So right profile plane. Suppose you are having towards left hand side, you get the left profile plane. My point P lies at a distance of 60 mm above HP, 70 mm in front of HP, and 30 mm from right profile plane, like this. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Understood? Okay. So this what I represented here now, I'm going to represent including views. Okay, no need to draw this one, not required. It's very complicated. Just you draw this views. Okay. So 40 mm is this is 40 mm. This is 40 mm. 40 mm. Okay. So take a distance of 40 mm from this line. From this line, draw a reference line x1, y1. Okay. Over.
So where is the right profile plane?
This one. Okay. This one is the right profile plane. This one. Okay. This one is right profile plane.
Sir, I can't see your head is coming.
This one, not seeing. This plane.
Oh, okay, sir. Thank you. Okay.
This is right profile plane. What you are seeing this one now? This is your vertical plane.
Okay, sir.
And this is your right profile plane.
Got it. Thank you.
And this is your horizontal plane.
Okay, sir.
Next, how to draw your side view? Okay, already you drew a front view, and all of you are following. Planes analyzed properly. Any doubts?
Yes, sir.
Good. Okay. Next, to draw the side view, to add the side view to this, what we are going to do? Okay. First, you draw, because they give the dimension clearly in the problem. It is 40 mm from right profile plane. Okay. Suppose if they give right profile plane, always you have to take towards right hand side. Suppose if they give a 40 mm from LPP, in that case you have to take towards left hand side. Okay, so clearly mentioned R2P is right profile plane. If it is LPP, you have to take towards of this one line. I understood. Okay, so whatever projection lines you are having, next step, take 40 mm distance, draw one vertical line and mark that line as x1, y1. Over.
Got it, for you, sir.
Okay. And so where you get the top view? It is below the reference line, right? Top view.
Yes, sir.
That side, what you can do, you are having one intersection point right here. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. From this line, draw a line at an angle of 45 degree. You bisect this line. Okay. 45 degree. This one also 45 degree. So draw a line at an angle of 45 degree. So you remember where you are having the top view, that side you have to draw the 45 degree line. Don't draw here. Okay. So keep in mind while drawing the side view, first you analyze whether it is RPP or LPP. If it is RPP, you have to take towards right hand side. If it is LPP, you have to take towards left hand side. Okay. So where you are having, so you have to analyze here. Here my front view and here is my top view. This side you have to draw 45 degree line to locate the side view. Okay. All of you finished. First you draw 45 degree line.
Excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, those arrows, can we draw normal arrows or we should dark it, sir? Like you did normal arrows.
This one arrow, right?
Yes, sir.
Line should be thin and arrow should be thick, remember.
Okay, sir.
Line thin and arrow, what I mentioned, no, here arrow.
Yes, sir.
It should be thick.
Okay, sir.
And point should be highlighted. And remaining all should be thin lines only. Okay, thin lines, all thin lines.
Okay, sir.
But it should be visible. Don't write too much thin line.
So why have you given that angle, sir?
Quarter. What is your doubt?
Have you given that angle?
Huh?
So you have written on 45 degree, no, sir?
Uh-huh, 45 degree.
So why is it so, or is it?
To locate the side view, this is the representation. I'm explaining the step, okay? You write first, okay? I'll explain after that, okay? Steps, okay. I'm explaining now. To add the side view, you have to analyze where is your top view, okay? That side, so you are having an intersection of XY and X1, Y1. From that intersection point, draw a line at an angle of what? Just draw the line. But you should take exactly 45 degree. Don't make any mistake here. So perfectly, you have to bisect this 90 degree into 45 degree. That's why. So measure carefully, either from this side or this side. Okay. Just you draw one line at an angle of 45 degree. Okay. Don't take 46 or 47. So measure with your protractor. Okay.
Sir? On which side the top view is there? At that side we have to draw the 45
degree. Good. Correct. Okay. That's why I'm telling where you are having, after drawing front view and top view, we are having top view below the reference line. That side. Okay. This side. So top view is here. This side only, you have to draw 45 degree. Suppose sometimes my top is here. In that case, you have to draw 45 degree line here. Okay.
Okay, sir.
That's why keep in mind where you are having top view, that side only you have to draw 45 degree line. Suppose if you are drawing 45 degree line here, it is wrong. Okay. Will not get correct position. Okay. So to add the side view, so always analyze top view first, okay, then locate the intersection point, and from that intersection point, you have to draw 45 degree line, okay? All of you draw 45 degree line?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next step. So you are having this line point P, right?
Yes, sir.
Sir, should we mark that point, sir?
Which one, sir?
From where we have taken 45 degrees.
45 degree, okay. So,
that
first,
point, sir.
I'm explaining. Okay, first, you draw XY line, already you have. Okay, next, you take 40 mm distance from this line. Okay, draw one more vertical line. Understood? You are having this line, right?
Yes, sir.
From this line, you take with the scale 40 mm. Okay. Measure 40 mm.
Yes, sir.
And so you have to draw a line. Which one?
This pencil mark. That pencil mark.
Excuse me. That means you can mute yourself. Yes, sir.
Okay, so after locating front view and side view, so you have to, because given clearly in the problem, you see 40 mm from RPP. Already you have this line with the scale, measure 40 mm, draw one vertical line. Okay, you take 40 mm from here, draw one vertical line, mark that line as X1, Y1.
Yes, sir, got it, sir.
Sir, on that line, X1, Y1, that no. Point, you know, sir.
With we dark
it, sir?
You have X1, Y1, right? After that, you drew a 45 degree line, right?
Yes, sir, we'll draw 45 degree angle, sir.
Okay.
We draw 45 degree angle. That point should be dark, sir.
Sir, the intersection point should be dark, sir.
No, no, intersection point is not required. Okay, just you locate the intersection point. From that intersection point, draw the 45 degree line. Enough. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay. Sir.
Just you draw 45 degree line. Finish, right? Okay. You finish?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next step, I'm explaining. You see, you observe carefully. You are having point P right here.
Yes, sir.
Okay. From this point, draw the horizontal straight line. From this point. Draw the horizontal straight line till it cuts the 45 degree line at some point. Okay, from point P, draw horizontal line. It should cut 45 degree line at somewhere. Somewhere it cuts. Okay, can you draw?
1 minute, sir.
Try. So after drawing 45 degree line, so from this point where you are having top view, extend the line. You have to draw perfect horizontal line till it cuts 45 degree line at some point.
Sir, should we join them or should we cut that 45 degree line using pizza?
No, no, just you extend the line, it cuts 45 degree line at some point, okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir.
Don't extend this one. Okay, enough. Just you extend the line till it cuts 45 degree line at some point. Over, students.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, all of you finished?
Yes, sir.
Okay, next step, from this line, draw a line, vertical line, exactly at an angle of 90 degree. Okay, so it should be perpendicular line. Okay, so draw a line. Just you draw one line. It should be at an angle of 90 degree. So you are having the point here. Next, you should draw a line at an angle of 90 degree. Draw vertical line.
Sir, any distance from the any distance, sir, like should we leave some gap?
No distance at all. Okay. So 45 degree already you are drawing right here. Then you are having some intersection point right here. Yes, from sir. This intersection point, okay, no, just you draw it simply, okay, no distance, nothing.
Okay, sir.
Just you extend the line, okay, no dimension. Simply you draw a line, that's it, at an angle of 90 degree, that's it, no dimension. But you have to maintain 90 degree here.
Done, sir.
Good. All of you are finished, students? All of you finished?
Yes, sir.
Good. Last step is you are having P dash, right?
Yes, sir.
From P dash, draw the horizontal line. Okay. Draw the perfect horizontal line. It cuts this line at some point. This is your side line. P dash, P double dash. Okay. So what lines you are having? No. Now what you can do? P dash you are having, right? Front view. Front view, just extend the line. Okay. It cuts that intersection line at some point. That point gives your side view. Okay. P double dash. Over, students.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Now you analyze. Okay. The front view and side view should lie on the same horizontal line. Next, you remember the front view and top view, it should lie on the vertical line. Okay, now see, the front view and top view lies on the vertical line. The front view and side view lies on the horizontal line, you see. This is how to draw the side view. Any doubts? Procedure for drawing the side view?
No, sir.
Okay, I'll explain once again. Okay, so while drawing the side view, you should keep in mind whether it is in right profile plane or it is in the left profile plane. If it is in the right profile plane, after drawing your front view and side view, top view, you have to take whatever distance given in the problem, draw vertical line towards right hand side. If it is from LPP, you have to take towards left hand side with that vertical line. So after drawing the vertical line, you have to mark this points as x1, y1. Okay, remember xy is the reference line for locating front view and top view, and x1, y1 is the reference line for locating the side view. Okay, next, after drawing this one, okay, so you have the intersection point, and here you should, it's most important. Okay, so where you are having the top view, that side you have to draw 45 degree line. Okay, that is most important. So don't draw here, okay, because here we are having front view. So where you are having top view, this is the most important point. Don't make any mistake here, okay. So where you are having the top view, because the top view is below the reference line, okay. So you have to take the 45 degree line that side only, okay. So from this, you are having intersection point, right? This is the intersection point of xy and x1, y1. So you have to draw a line at an angle of 45 degree. Don't make mistake here, okay. Don't take any angle. 46 is also wrong. You have to take exact 45 degree. The bisect that line into two parts, okay, 45 degree. Just you draw a line, no damage. Next step is, okay, so from the point B, just you draw a line. It cuts the 45 degree line at some point, okay. So this intersection point is most important, and from that intersection point, draw perfect 90 degree line. Okay, so once again, don't make a mistake here. Okay, you have to draw 90 degree line. Just you draw the line, okay, just you extend it, okay, whatever distance is, don't measure the distance. And final step is, from P dash, draw a horizontal line, so it cuts this line at some point. That intersection point is called as P double dash, side view. Side view is represented by double dash. Okay. Any doubts, students?
No, sir.
Good. Any, suppose you're having any doubts, ask me. Okay.
No, sir.
Okay, good. So, like that. So already you know front view and top view, how to draw. You understood location, everything. Okay, only side view you have to analyze properly. Okay, so where you are having the top view, that side you have to draw 45 degree line. Okay. So now I'll take the attendance. After that, I'll give some assignments. Okay. So you have to practice a lot, try to understand the concept. Abhishek Sridhar.
Present, sir.
Next, Ba Hamid, number two. Number two.
Present.
Number three. Ba Wazir Muhammad Ali.
Present, sir.
Okay. Number four, Benton Biju.
Present, sir.
Number five, Darshini KJ.
Present, sir.
Number 6, Harshita P.
Present, sir.
Number 7, Hemant A. Number 7, Hemant.
Yes, sir.
Number 8, Krisha M.
Present, sir.
Number 9, Krutika CK.
Present, sir.
Okay. Krishika CK present, right? Nishant Y.
Present, sir.
Krutika present, Krutika CK?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Nitin Swami.
Present, sir.
Prajwal N.
Present, sir.
Shefali Ravindran.
Present, sir.
Sri Vidya Shashidhar.
Present, sir.
Okay. Lavinia Vijay Kumar.
Present, sir.
Syed Najish Shamin. Syed Najish. Absent. So guys, don't miss the class. Suppose you're not understanding any concept. Okay. Suppose you miss one class also, you'll not understand any concept. Okay. It's very difficult to analyze for the next concept. That's why attend all the classes regularly and you do all the assignments properly. Okay. Next, Samriddhi Raj.
A present, sir.
Nitish MS.
Sir, present, sir. For him, some network issues, sir.
Who?
The class, sir.
Who at?
Sir, Nitish MS.
Okay. Sagar N. Sagar N. Absent or present or having any issues? Sagar N, number 19. Sahana Hasmani.
Present, sir.
M. Shashank. Shashank M. Lakshmi Narayan K.R.
Sir, present, sir.
Janavi Harish. Janavi Harish.
Present, sir.
Rangi Saran Sripath.
Yes, sir.
Anusha Adav.
Present, sir.
Ashnil I.
Present, sir.
Rohan Patil.
Present, sir.
Bhargav Teja. Bhargav Teja. Kushalappa. Kushalappa.
Present, sir.
Hemant Kumar KH.
Present, sir.
Trupti K. Trupti K. Varun V. Apeksha.
Present, sir.
Shrey Aditya.
Present, sir.
Nishant Patil. Nishant Patil. Kevin Alfred.
Present, sir.
Okay. Okay. Now I'll change the same problem you explained. Okay. Okay, guys, I change the problem. Okay, can you analyze first? Okay, I'll dictate the problem. First, draw all the three views of a point Q lying 60 mm below HP, 60 mm behind VP. Okay. Okay. And 40 mm from LPP. Okay, all of you note down.
Excuse me, sir.
Tell me.
Is that an assignment or if you are doing that sum?
No. It is an assignment. Okay. Now, before that, first you have to analyze. Tell me how you are going to do this problem. Okay. All of you note down. This has an assignment. Okay. So I change the position. Okay. Draw all the three views of a point Q lying 60 mm below HP, 60 mm behind VP, and 40 mm from LPP. Okay. So can you tell which quadrant it is first? That is important. Okay.
The third quadrant.
Third quadrant. Forget about side view. First you analyze front view and top view. Okay. It lies in third quadrant, right? Where you get your front view and top view? Next step.
So top view above reference plane and front view below reference plane.
Good. Okay, you analyze this one much. Okay. Next step. How to draw your side view? 40 mm from LPP.
Sir, 40 mm left side, sir.
Good. Okay. So that's why you have to analyze step by step. Okay, anyhow, this is assignment. Still, I'll explain how to draw this one. Okay, here it is XY, your reference line. My point lies in the third quadrant, that is Q lying 60 mm below HP. So you take 60 mm below the reference line, mark that point as Q dash. Okay, so this is your 60 mm. Okay. It is in third quadrant. You are going to rotate the horizontal plane in the clockwise direction, means my point goes, the top view goes above the reference line. Okay, this is the first step. Okay, just you understand the procedure. After that, you can draw it. Okay. Just you try to analyze the concept. Okay, next, it is 60 mm. Okay. So after drawing your front view and top view, so you have to draw the side view. So it is, they are given side view, they are given 40 mm from LPP. What you can do, you have to take towards left hand side now. Okay, towards left hand side, draw one vertical line, mark that line as x1, y1. Okay. Now can you tell me where you are going to draw your 45 degree line, guys?
Sir, above, sir.
Good. So first you have to analyze where is your intersection point. This is your intersection point. Once analyzing intersection point, next analyze where is your top view. Top is this side, right? Above. Means you have to draw 45 degree line here. Okay. So you remember 45 degree line changes according to the position of the point lies in a particular quadrant. So in this case, so we are having intersection point here, this side. Okay, keep in mind to draw the 45 degree line is most important. We have to analyze where the top view is. It is the top view is above the reference line. That side you have to draw 45 degree line. Okay. Next step, anybody how to explain how to complete this one? Anybody?
So at Q and Q dash.
No, where you are having side, you know, that side only you have to take. Okay, here you are having intersection point. So here from Q, you draw a line in the left side direction till it cuts the 45 degree line at some point. So here in this case, 45 degree line is here. Then you have to start with top view. Okay, first top view, from this point draw a line perfect horizontal line. It cuts 45 degree line at some point. Next step, anybody? You have to draw your vertical line exactly at an angle of 90 degree. This one, just you draw the line. First step, locate front view, side view. Okay, next, it is 40 mm from LPP. Okay, so you draw a line at a distance of 40 mm towards left hand side. So you draw vertical line, mark the line as x1 y1 where you are having top side, that side you have to draw 45 degree line. From the top view, just draw the horizontal line, then vertical line at an angle of 90 degree. Then what is the next step, guys? Last step.
So draw a horizontal line from Q dash.
Correct. Draw the horizontal line. Q dash. Just you draw the horizontal line. So it meets this point. Okay. And this point is your side view, and mark that point as Q double dash. Okay, you remember the front view and top view are in the same vertical line. The front view and side view are in the same horizontal line. Okay, hope understood. Yes. Any doubts? Any doubts?
No, sir.
No, sir.
So, in today's class, we discussed the position of point in different quadrant, the position of point exactly lying on HB, exactly lying on VP, and also how to draw the side view. Okay, once you understand this concept, so we can draw any number of problems. So we can do any number of problems. Okay, guys, meantime, all of you have to enter your roll number and name in the chat box without fail. Okay. So those who have joined, so all of you have to enter, please, your name in the chat box. Everyone enter, okay, roll number and name in the chat box. And those who are not joined Google Classroom, please join today only, and I'll share the assignments in the Google Classroom, okay? So there only you have to submit your assignment.
Excuse me, sir.
Nah, tell me.
Sir, can I get the recording of today's class? Because of network issue, I did not get many things. So I want to see it once again.
Yeah, definitely. I'll share, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Any other things? Any doubts? Okay, suppose you're having any notes, please feel free to ask, okay. Regarding planes, projection lines, dimension lines, most important, okay. Okay, I'll stop the session now. I hope all of you entered your name and roll number in the chat box, okay. I'll stop the session now.